right. Well, in honor of Mother's Day, we've got a live chat question for you, Terry.
Okay.
And Angela says, Terry, as a mother, I feel like there's never enough of me to go around. I imagine you felt that way on occasion. And on rare occasion that I do take time for myself, I have mommy guilt. How do you deal with this?
Well, it's taken me a long time to get to the place where I could get past that. But what I came to realize when there finally wasn't enough to me of me to go around because I'd spent myself, that if you don't take that time to refill, you don't have anything to give. And hopefully some of that refill time includes time of refreshment with the Lord. He just kind of puts it all back in order again, you know, makes you feel like you're not losing your mind. It really has some sane purpose to all of it. And I think that also I had to come to the realization that I was not the answer to everything that my children needed, especially now that my kids have gotten older. I'm finding that my life is supposed to be pushing them to Him. And if my life is drawing them to me, then I'm doing something wrong. And so, you know, you kind of, in a mom's heart, there's that thing that says, I need to be all things to all of these people in my household. And you really need to ask
the
Lord.
And for a time, you are.
Yeah, for a time, you are. And it is very draining. But you need those mommy moments. I suggest a warm bath.
A box of chocolates.
Yeah, that works for me. We all know that, right?
A nice cup of coffee.
That's right.
And one more. You know, in marriage, there's this thing called a husband.
Yeah.
And every once in a while, you can say, here.
Yeah.
You know, I need to take some time.
I highly recommend that.
And I used to delight in giving Catherine a day off here.
Yeah.
You know, it's my turn.
So it's not just your turn. It's so important.
And then she would delight
children.
In giving them to me at 4 a.m.
Yeah.
And...
yeah. See, it all has a sort of a symbiotic flow to
your
it.
Turn.
Okay, this is a question. Carolyn says, I'm a 35-year-old mother of three. I've done everything you can imagine that's bad in this life. Now I'm ready to turn my life over to God and follow Him. How do I hear God's voice? I don't want to make the wrong decisions again.
Carolyn, the best way to hear God's voice is open the Bible and start reading that. It's God's love letter to all His children. And just immerse yourself in it. I'd encourage you to start with the Gospel of John. That's a gospel of love. And then read all four of the Gospels and just spend time meditating. And if you want to, just read the verses in red. And those are the words of Jesus. And the more you get familiar with those, then you understand His voice. And then there's a wonderful prayer that Paul put in the Bible, and that is that God would open our ears and open our eyes and give us a heart to understand. And that's a prayer you can pray, and literally you can pray it every day. And just say, Jesus, I want to hear Your voice. Holy Spirit, I want to know You. You say You're my helper, You're my friend. Well, I want to know You. And the more you do that, the more you seek His face, and the more you get used to His voice, the more you get. It's my father calls it the law of use. When you put things to use and start asking, then you get them, and you get very familiar with that voice, and you don't have to worry about other strange voices. Jesus.